Time now to take 5 minutes with another party leader. Today, national affairs correspondent Omar Sachedina sat down with the NDP's Jagmeet Singh.
Mr. Singh, it's good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
Your platform pledges more than $200 billion in spending over the next 5 years and relies on new taxes on the so-called ultra-rich and also corporations as well to generate more revenue. Do you not run the risk of killing innovation at a time when economic growth is so important for Canada's post-pandemic recovery?
No, not at all. What we're looking at is just fairness. It's about making sure the folks that are using offshore tax havens and loopholes that mean that they're not paying their fair share start to pay their fair share. And so it's just really a question of fairness when we see workers that have struggled in this pandemic, small businesses that have to shut their door, but we see the wealthiest 44 billionaires in Canada increase their wealth by $78 billion and continue not to pay their fair share. It's something that Canadians say doesn't sit well with them.
To Trans Mountain now. Mm-hmm. You say that you're against it. You've said that repeatedly. Mm-hmm. But you won't say what you'll do with it. Don't voters deserve to know what your plan is?
Well, voters know where I stand, and they know where I stand.
But they don't know what you're going to do with it.
Well, they know where I stand on the environment, and they know the things that I would concretely do right away. They know that I would end fossil fuel subsidies while Mr. Trudeau increased them.
But Mr. Singh, with respect, the question was specifically with Trans Mountain, which, as you know, is now a taxpayer-owned asset. If you're elected, what will you do with it? Will you keep it or will you get rid of it?
Well, I've always learned, my mom always taught me, that we need to make sure we make good decisions. And a good decision is only made when you know what you're up against. We don't know what Mr. Trudeau has done, and we don't know the situation. Until we're in government, we'll know that better.
If you want to assess the decision whether to keep it or sell it, what's the criteria there? What will you be looking at?
All the parameters involved with making a decision. What's in the best interest of Canadians? What's the state of the asset? What's the best decision possible we can take?
I want to move on to Bill 21. This is an issue where, for you, the personal and the political really collide, right? If you were in Quebec, you would not be able to be a public prosecutor, even a teacher. The Liberals are at least open to intervening in a legal challenge. Are you?
Well, what I've said about this bill is that it's being fought right now in court. It's a bill that's divisive, and I don't support those type of bills.
But the question was very direct, Mr. Singh. Will you intervene? Are you at least open to intervening, or are you not?
Well, my position is it's being fought in court right now, and it's important that it's fought in court. And as a lawyer, I know that these decisions can be very complex, and so I wouldn't assess anything before we know what happened.
Is it racist?
Calling people racist or labeling things as racist is less important to me than actually getting the results. And the results for me would be a society where people belong, where we don't have police violence based on someone's color of their skin, where people are not being treated differently because of who they are. That's what I want to achieve.
If you think this bill is discriminatory, then
I don't think it is.
Then why are you not at least open to the possibility of challenging it legally?
We'll see what happens with it. You know, I've seen a lot of court cases, and the results are very complicated, and the rulings can be very complex, and so we want to know what the results are.
We are now just a few days away from September 20th. If it is a Conservative minority and you hold the balance of power, will you work with that scenario?
I'm going to flip that up because I'm not going to accept defeat. I'm fighting to become Prime Minister. As Prime Minister, my goal is to tax the super wealthy.
But which you've talked about, but the likelihood of that happening is not great at this point, right?
But I'm not going to accept that frame.
There are two front runners right now. If it is a Conservative minority, would you be willing to work with that government?
It doesn't change. I'm not going to accept that frame. I'm running to become Prime Minister, and as Prime Minister, I would achieve what I promised to do, which is to invest in our childcare, to invest in solving the housing crisis, to invest in our health care, to tax the super wealthy. And I want Canadians to know they've got a choice. If they want these things to happen, you got Mr. Trudeau, who's all for show, says a lot of great things, all for show, but it's protected the interests of the rich. Or you've got new Democrats who are going to fight for you. We're going to make sure the super wealthy pay their fair share and invest in the solutions that people need.
Mr. Singh, thank you for your time, and congratulations to you and your wife as you embark on parenthood.
Thanks so much. Appreciate that.